Hello everyone.
Hello, teacher.
How
You're doing great.
Hello, teacher.
are you today? Yeah. Yeah. It's nice to
Hi,
meet you in
teacher.
class. So we start now. First, I would like to say thank you, all of you. You asked around the time, your time to stand this class at this time. Yeah, this time. Because after this class, I will have a writing, doctoral writing committee. I'll ask you last about maximum is still to the 3 p.m. And after that, I must join the doctoral writing committee of the GVS. And before we go to the detail of the course, and I will just I first I will do. Introduce you, introduce about our course and how we study, and how this was document, textbook, and how we assess the assessment of the course. Firstly, I will introduce please introduce of myself. Yes, my name is Trần Đăng Khoa. And now he has head of strategic management division, and I'm also the director of the management program. And that's the program you're studying now. Now I'm teaching some subject in the US. First, that's the management and strategic management. Strategic implementation, corporate social responsibility, and design thinking for business, and developing management skills. And about my some my background experience, about working experience, I have more than 12 years working in the telecom and IT field, and before. Before I joined the GVS, and I used to be working as the position as the Deputy General Director of an IT and telecom and IT company with more than 250 engineers in Ho Chi Minh City. And after hosting the PhD degree in 2008, I joined US in 2009. And now I'm teaching on the program in BA, MBA, and PhD. And I also do some do many research. So I think if you can. In your during your programs, if you want to want me to help you advise about your research, you can ask me. I will help you to do your research. As my research field as on CSR, corporate social responsibility, and strategic management and human resource management and about marketing. Yeah, those are my research fields. And I has many publications and some of them has been public in famous journal on the Web Science and Scopus. So I think if you I really to help you if you want me to help you to advise your research during your programs. And before we go to the introduction, I want to ask you some questions. The first question is I want you to share why do you choose to study the management program? Please share your reasons why.
Okay. My name is Yang, and I want to share some of my experience about management major.
Yeah.
So I haven't had a specific future plan, but I want to study management because I want to be a manager in the future. That of course everybody in the class goal, but beside that, I think study management will help me to improve my teamwork.
Yeah,
I think it's really effective to do the teamwork if we learn how to manage a group or an organization.
That's very good vision.
Yeah.
And what else? Yeah, thank you, Miss Yang. And all the students, you can share your reason why you choose to study the management program.
Hello, Mr. Kwan.
Yes.
My name is Wong. And the reason why I choose to study management course is that I study in high school, and many of my friends told me that I'm quite suitable as a leader. So I guess that my personality is suitable for the management course, and I want to improve that aspect of my characteristic.
Yeah, and you want to be a leader in future?
Yes.
Right. Yeah. Very good.
Thank you.
And the others.
Yes, teacher. Can I answer the question?
Yeah.
Just like Zhang, I don't really have a specific goal in my mind right now. So I choose management because I want to have a role knowledge in the field of business, so that I can know about bit by bit a little bit of everything, and maybe in the future I got to choose the career that fit me the most. Yes, that's my number one reason for choosing to study management. Yes, and to be honest, I realized that my interpersonal skill and also communication skill is like extremely bad. Yes, and I hope that by enrolling in the management course and in the next 4 years, I can improve my soft skill and also expand my network with the people in the same field. Yes, and that's my goal, my answer.
Yeah, thank you, Ms. Han. Yeah, I think you have chose the right program to improve your ability.
Yes, thank you very much for your comment.
Yeah. And the next question what is your expectation from this program? That means the management program. What is your expectation?
Can I answer questions, teacher? For this program, my expectations are, of course, the first is to pass this program and move on to the other programs up schools. But also from this program, I want to learn more to understand what is the meaning of management. And also, I hope that this knowledge will be able to help me achieve more success in the future and help me to find a job easier.
Yeah, thank you for sharing, Mr. Vũ. And about maybe Mr. Thinh, you just turn off your camera. And Ms. Nguyen, what are your expectations from the program?
Yes.
So I think management is, do you want to say something, Tan? Do you want to say first? And I will go then.
You, Ms. Nguyen, you can continue and with
everything. My connection is not really good, so I answer was slow. So you answer first, please.
Okay, so I think that management is a really important skill for me, like in every aspect of life. And I expect that after learning this program, I can like broaden my knowledge in this field and also sharpen my skill so that I can be a better leader in the future. And also get the good mark too.
Yes, sorry. Yes, thank you, Ms. Nguyen. And Mr. Thinh, can you say something about your expectations?
My expectation is nothing really special. I hope that from this program, I can improve my English and also learn about how to manage myself, because I'm not really the person that will follow a schedule. So I think that from this program, I know how to set goal for myself, and of course, can expand my networking, so I can meet many friends, and of course, can find a better job in the future.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Thinh. Yes. Okay. I think it's the program and the environment of the school of management to help you to improve your ability and may satisfy your expectation. And so I will introduce some brief information about our program. I just introduced about the program objectives of the management. That's the objectives of the management start after a few years after graduation. You can first, you can be excellent as the management profession in an organization. So maybe in the business, government, and NPO. Non-profit organizations. And the second, that you can conduct a higher education program, maybe an MBA or PhD in management or in business administration. Or you can become a researcher in the field of management or business administration. And the third, that you can in about your still, you can always show responsible concerns to stakeholders when making decision. And the last, you can be assigned to the mid or the top level of management position in the future. So this program is to help you to be a leader and the manager in the future, and the middle and the top manager in the future. But you know, that's a few years, maybe about 4 or 5 years after graduation, you can have ability to promote to the middle and the top manager in organizations, most in business, government, and NPO. That's about the role and objective of the management role. And now I go to the introduction of the management course. This course, the course, yeah. First, yeah, I want to tell you about how is the management course important in the management program. Yeah, I will tell you how important of this course to on your program about 3 years, more than 2 years. Yes, do you know this logo?
Yes.
Yes.
The Microsoft company logo.
Yes, I think all of you know this logo. That's the Microsoft. And the most famous of Microsoft, what program must be most famous of Microsoft?
Windows.
Yes, Windows. Yeah. And I think all of you know this logo, yeah. What's it about? What is it about? Is it about?
This is the Apple operating system.
Yeah. Of what company?
By Apple.
Yeah, by Apple. Yeah. And this logo?
Android.
Yes, Android. Yeah. So what is the similarity of the three logos?
They are all software company.
Oh, software. What kind of software?
Like technology.
Technology. Yeah.
Operating system.
Operating system. Yeah. Good. Yes, all those are operating system. And why? Yeah. Why? Can you guess? Why? When I interview about management course, I say about the operating systems. Why? Who can guess what's the implication?
I think you implied that management is about operating a company or or any system.
Yeah, thank you. It's very good. Yeah, I use the operating system. I want to say that management course, this course for the field of management, this course is like, yeah, it's the same to the operating system in your computer or in your smartphone. You know, with the operating system, yeah, we can install many kind of software, so that can help you to solve your problem and to help you to entertainment and your work and your study. But it depends on the operating system in your computer or your phone. And management course, that's also like the operating system that help you, that's give you the foundation and the framework of management. So based on this framework and foundation, you can install more. Yeah, wait a moment. Yeah, we can install more about the knowledge and skill in the skill of management to help you. That's you can explain about the role overall, yeah, about this management course, this course. Okay. And next, I will introduce you about the course learning outcome. Yeah, that means after finish the course, what you can get, you can has your ability and your skill, you are still get what you can get from after you finish this course. First, about the knowledge. About the knowledge, there are five learning outcomes about knowledge. First, you can this course you can describing the and distinguishing the concept in management, maybe the organization manager management and organization environment management decision. You can distinguish. Yeah, describing and distinguishing. Yes. And the second that you can understanding and be able to apply the four functions of management, that planning, organizing, leading, and controlling to your specific situation. Yeah, you can apply in your situation. And third, you can discussing decision type. That's maybe about the decision making and the decision making capability in your situation. And the post that about you can analyzing the organization operating environment and the impact of the environment to the business, to your organization, and you can analyze and make your organization flexible to adapt the environment. And the last of the knowledge that you can analyzing and evaluating governance situation, governance practice in the iteration and innovation of the innovation. And about the skill, after the course, you can developing the ability to practice independently and flexibly in your STEAM work, and you can develop your ability to give a statement, argument, discussion, maybe you can develop in your role in the course, and about the autonomy and flexibility, you can have the rules, understanding of the risk roles of environment. Organizational management in the context of today's innovation and community business environment today. That's about your course learning outcomes. And about the textbook, our course, we will study, we based on this textbook management. Maybe you can also the other name, the new era of management, of the author Richard Graham. This is a very famous textbook. Many top universities in the world use this textbook for the management course. And this textbook. Has some difference from the textbook I upload to the LMS, your last in LMS system. It because that because of the intellectual poverty laws, I cannot upload because this it lost the I cannot send you in the MF lab, but I can send this textbook for you personal. I send this textbook to you through your monitor, and your monitor will share the textbook for all of you. You can study this lab. So I will and then I review you the content of the textbook and what you will study in this course. This textbook consists of 19 chapter. Many chapter. 19 chapter. Yeah. And those chapter, I divide it into six parts. Yeah, six parts. The part one about the introduction of management. There are two chapters. Chapter one, the rules of innovative management, and we will study chapter today. And chapter two, the evolution of management thinking. That's about the part one. And in part two, we have four chapters. Chapter three, the environment and corporate culture. Chapter four, management, managing in the global environment. We will study about the environment, but about the global context. And chapter five, managing ethics and social responsibility. This is ethics and social responsibility now is a very hot topic in management environment today. Yeah, so you can study this the third day. And the chapter six, managing startups in and new ventures. You can see the color in red. The chapter with the red color, and that's a chapter you will study yourself. Self study. Because it's the limit of time. We just has 9 days. Yeah, and we cannot go on the rules step by step on the chapter in this textbook. So some textbook you will study by yourself. You can read the textbook, yeah, and study by yourself. And the chapter, the part three, there are three chapters. Part three about planning. Yeah, we will study chapter seven, planning and setting goal setting. That's about we study about what kind of plans in an organization, and how to setting goals, yeah, how to make a plan. And the chapter six, strategy formulation and execution. This chapter about a very important plan for a business or organizations. That's about the strategy. Yeah. And you will you also this chapter you self study for yourself, your self study. And you will have this we have a subject a course for strategy. After maybe in the third or the fourth semester. And the chapter nine about managerial decision making. We study about the decision. decision and how, đúng không ạ? How the manager to make decision. And part core, that's the organizing. There are four chapters in this part. Yeah. Chapter 10, designing designing organizational structure. You will study what kind of structure of the there are the different kind of structure in organization, and each structure that's suitable for the purpose. Yeah. So you study how to choose the structure for your organization. And the chapter 11, you study about managing change and innovation. That's about how to make your organization changing and how to put the innovation to your organization. And chapter 12 and chapter 13, you also self study with chapter 12 and 13. Yeah. Chapter 12 about managing human resource. Yeah. You will have all the subjects about the human resource management. And the chapter 13 about managing diversity. That's you know today in a company or in an organization, there are men, the employees in the company or organization, they vary this different. So how you organize and managing the difference of the employee in the company, that's chapter 13. And part five leading, there are five chapters in this part five. Chapter 14, understanding individual behavior. This chapter you also self study too. Yeah. And I will introduce you the chapter 15, leadership. Yeah. How to influence to order and the chapter 16, motivating employees, yeah, how to motivate order to work, yeah. And chapter 17, we study about managing communication, yeah, self study too, but you self study. And chapter 18, leading teams, we will study, and I think it's very important and some of you will tell about the teamwork. Yeah, we will study how to organize the team and how you enjoy to join the team to work and how lead the team. Yeah, we will study in chapter 18. And the part 6, there only one chapter. There is only one chapter, controlling. Chapter 19, yeah, managing quality and performance. So there are 19 chapter, and we will study 13 chapter. We study, I will introduce you, and we will discuss in last 13 chapter, and 6 chapter you shall study by reading your textbook. So on the chapter with the color in red, that is your self-study. Chapter 6 and chapter 8, chapter 12 and chapter 13, chapter 14 and chapter 17. Yeah, 6 chapter, yeah. And there's course teaching plan. We have 9 days to study this course. And day one, yeah, today, first I will introducing the management course. And after that, we will study the chapter one, innovative management for the changing world. Chapter one. And in day two, we will study chapter two, the evolution of management thinking, and the chapter three, corporate culture and environment. And day three, we study chapter four, chapter five, managing in a global environment, and chapter five, ethics and social responsibility. And day four, in day four, we just study the chapter seven, planning and setting goal setting, and you study yourself, chapter six and chapter eight. And day five, I introduce you now chapter nine and chapter 10. And day six, there are two chapters you can sell with yourself, study on the chapter 12 and chapter 13. And I introduce you, and we will discuss in the last chapter 11, change and innovation. And day seven, also we shall study the chapter 14, and we will discuss in last the chapter 15 and 16. Let's wait a moment, Lee. And day six, day eight, we will discuss about the chapter 18, teamwork, and day nine, about chapter 19, and after that, we had course review, and we do the midterm test. In day nine, remember that you will have a midterm test in day nine, the last day of the course. And what you should do to prepare for the last. First, I want you to read, read the textbook, and my PowerPoint, I have sent you textbook and PowerPoint. That I want to read before you attend the last. And participant and attend the last pool on the night class, and discuss in the last, share your idea and ask question, in the last, in your last. And about teaching method. this due to the online. So if you study offline, I will divide you into team, and I ask you to prepare and make your presentation. First, with the online last, it's difficult for you to teamwork, and it's difficult for you to make your presentation. So I adjust my teaching method. First, I will introduce the lesson. And during my introducing, you can ask question and discuss the question. Discuss my question or discuss your classmate's question. I want you to discuss. And after that, we will do the multiple choice question. That's help you to review the knowledge of the chapter of the lesson, and this is a chance for you to get the mark. And and finally about the assessment. There are two columns of the assessment. Process assessment and final test. And process assessment, you have 70% of the total call, the cost of your cost, total 70%. And the final test, only about 30%. So I think it's very important for you about the process assessment. There are three columns in your process assessment. First, the wisdom test. You will do a multiple choice question with 100 questions in about 2 hours. And you can guess maximum 10 marks. And you will have some bonus for your process assessment. First, about dedication in last. Each day, if you have a dedication means that you can ask question, or you answer my question, or you answer your last minute question, as dedication in last. And a day, if you have dedication in last, you will have less 0.5 points per day, not the time per day. So I really want all of you because in our last every day. I really want of you. So you can get many points from the discussion. For example, there are nine days and the total. For example, today, with the that you have a question or answer question, we will check that one. Only one, because you ask more 2-3 questions. Just I know that you have discussed in the last. You had discussion in the last. So check one. For example, and total, so I will zoom on the day you have discussed in your last, zoom, and multiple weeks, 0.5. For example, you can you discuss every day, So we have 4.5 for your bonus to the process, the process assessment. It's easy for you to get your mark in process, And I hope that all of you try to get the bonus, the bonus mark. And the other bonus that each chapter we will have about 30 or 40 or 50 multiple choice question we will have them. And I have divided you into 19. I had divided you, and I has upload this file to your last in the device 19. So when we do the multiple choice question, you check the total cost of each team, and the highest score, the team with highest score will be bonus 0.5 points for every member of the team. But of course, the member they attend the last day. So you can also get many. We have 11. We may work with 30 chapter. Many opportunities, many chance for you to get your process. To get your progress. That's a point, and you can get this very important that this way about 70%. And the final tab, you will write an assignment. That's the maximum 5 pages. I will give you the topic after the course. In the last day, and you will prepare in 2 weeks. 2 weeks, you will write an assignment. That's the on of my introduction about the management course. And have you any question? Any question? If you want to make clear some point in my introduction, you can ask me a question so we can make clear.
Teacher, I want to ask that. The bonus points only apply to the midterm test, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you for the
if the total more than I understand. You mean that if the total more than 10 marks, you can get maximum 10 marks of the process assessment.
Oh, I see. Yes.
Yeah. And any other question? Who is the monitor of your class? It's Thảo Nguyên. I need you help me to check the education of your last mate. I mean, you can download there to read first read about education checklist. You can download to your computer, and the second ask about the team. Lead up your team, so you can download to your computer. And every day, I need you help me to check whether your language has the discussion in the last. And check for my day. When we doing the multiple choice question, I think I need other people. Maybe your vice monitor. who are the vice heads of your class?
Miss Thu.
Miss Thu, yeah. I mean, You are Thảo Nguyên.
Yes.
Yeah, you are Thảo Nguyên. And Thanh Thương. Có Thanh Thương. Yeah. Yeah. And I meet Võ Thanh Thương, help me when we are doing this multiple choice question. To help me to check. Yeah. To check the score, the total score of each team. And after the finish, we finish the multiple choice question. You tell me what team had a high score. So I will for example, after multiple choice question, team one had a high score. So every member of the team will have 0.5 bonus point, for example, and there's not day, that's about kata. Bây giờ chapter 1, for example, view has. Yeah, I will press that. And it's dependent, etc. And I will bonus for the team with the highest score. So when you answer my multiple choice question, you must show what team you belong to. So Mr. Thanh Thương, we will just check. And when you finish with Thanh Thương, you tell us what team it has high score in last day in that chapter. Thanh Thương, you hear me? Thanh Thương. Yeah, okay. I recommend that all of you prepare your mic because we we check with the question if you turn on your mic, your microphone, and you ask or you answer question. If you type in this chat box, it's not. I think it's not a discussion question. It's discussion in the world, in the last. You must turn on your microphone. Do you understand? Yeah. Thank you. Okay, and now we go to the chapter 1, innovative management for changing world. So from now, Miss Thảo Nguyên, from now you can check, you will repair your list and check who discuss.
Yes, teacher.
Yeah, thank you. And there are chapter outline of the chapter 1. Yeah, 9 item you will discuss in this chapter. Firstly, you will answer the questionnaire. Yeah, and if you check, you ready to be a manager? you will check. You ask your questionnaire, I will tell you. And after that, we will discuss about why innovative management matter today. And the definition of management. And after that, we discuss about the four management functions. And about the organizational performance. And there's fifth, that's about as we will discuss about the management skills. Yeah. What the management, what the skill management need to do the management functions. And after that, about the management time. And what item seven, that's what it's like to be a manager. That's why, you know. And after that, we discussed about managing a small business and non-profit organizations. And the last content, we discussed that the management competencies today. And about it. And first, you will do the check. Are you ready to be a manager? Yeah, you are welcome to the work of management. And are you ready for this?
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you. And this you will see the question with the A question. And you must choose the four question. The A question does that define the A work that's the new manager can do. It's the following item based on what you think is the appropriate emphasis for the task that start that your success as a new manager of a department. You image that you are new manager of a department in the company. So there are six tasks you can you have to do. But I want you to choose to pick out four tasks you think high priority. And of course, the other four are the low priority. So you will list, you list the A star and pick out what star for the four, pick out. The four tasks, what's the priority for the new manager of a department in the company? Please and choose, and you ask me what your answer is. I'm sorry that I stop and I use record. I record. Okay. We also record. Okay. Oh, many of you raise your hand. Okay, first, Hoàng Ali Alihan Turan.
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah.
Can you turn? Oh.
What item? I will to you. You can you just answer what the number of task you choose as a high priority. Thưa
dạ thầy ơi, máy sorry Miss Teachers, the computer of Turan is shut down, so can you wait a minute?
Yeah okay, so Miss thank you, me too. And Quỳnh Nhi.
Yes, I'm here. Can you return to the PowerPoint slides?
Yeah.
Okay, so my top four priorities are number four, implement the changes to believe in department performance, and number six, seven, and eight. Yeah,
these four, six, seven, and eight.
Yeah, four, six, seven, and eight.
Yeah, thank you, Huỳnh Nhi. And anh Vũ. Yeah, what is your question? Your answer. Anh Vũ, can you
can you hear me now?
Yeah, I hear. Yeah.
Yes. Okay. So my top four priorities are number two, number three, number seven, and number eight.
Yeah. Anh Vũ and number two, three, seven, and number eight.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you, Anh Vũ. And Quang Minh.
Yes, I'm here. Can you turn that back?
Yeah.
Okay, thanks. So the four top priority that for me is number three, number four, number five, and number seven.
Yeah, three, four, five, and seven. Yeah, thank you, Quang Minh.
Yes.
Yeah. And I want to the last one other question. Vân Nguyên.
I prioritize number 4, 6, 7, and 8.
Can you explain your answer?
Because I choose 4, 6, 7, and 8.
Yeah. Oh, six, seven, and eight. Yeah.
So, which one do you want me to explain?
Maybe number four. Why you choose number four?
I think that we should, you know, express our idea, and because if we are a manager, we should know how to make the thing that we believe into implement.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah. And other Mr. Quang Minh, can you explain your answer?
Yes, so the reason why I choose my priority is that since a lot of people rely on their feelings and mental health, and I want to care about that, and I want to set a relationship with them, so whenever there are any problems, I can talk directly to them, so there will be no distance between us.
Yeah, thank you. That's very interesting. Yeah, of your vision. Yeah. And the answer, yes, the item, the task, you the right task you should choose. That is number one. Yeah, no one choose number one. Yeah. And number three. Number one says spend 50% or more of your time to the care and feeding of people. Number one. And number three, you lunch to meet and network with peer in other departments. And number five, spend as much time as possible talking with and listening to subordinates. And number seven, yeah. Reach out to your boss to discuss his expectation for you and your department. Who choose this? Yeah, who to prize? Who has a prize answer for item most on for item? Who can choose? Who choose? When we, yeah. You want to ask question? Yeah. If you choose the right on the right answer with four item, it's very excellent. That's excellent. Yeah. To be you are really very ready to be a manager, to be the management world. And if you can choose three, yeah. You can choose three items. That's very good. Very good. And two is good. Good. And if you list them two, yeah, you will try to yeah, you can know why and you can improve yeah your thinking about management. And I see many people raise hand now. So what you want to ask me or?
Hello, can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
I just got one correct, which is yeah. Number seven. Yeah, I know that networking and like listening to the subordinates and other partners is really important. But when you spend most of your time, like 50% of your time to take care of their, like care for them or care about their feeding. So I just really want added explanation for that from you. Yeah, that's my question.
Yeah, thank you, Ms. Nhi. Yeah. And now I ask you a question, another question. So the correct answer is the item number 1, 3, 5, 7. And you can find what is the similarity of for task. The four tasks. What the same? What the same they are about?
It's the time you spend to care for others. Like,
time.
Yeah, to listen to others.
It's about the time we spend to care for others.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. It's very good. And other. Opinion or the ideas about.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh.
It's me. Can you hear me?
We speak louder.
So can you hear me clear now?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
So I see that you didn't choose number six, the sixth factor, which is punctuality. So why didn't we? So why do you think that the outcome, the punctuality of the outcome is not important as the other factors?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Kim Nguyen. It's a very interesting question. And I tell that on the task, a staff also important for manager on staff on six a staff also important for managers. But we must find out for tasks that you might set the higher priority to the other force. So I don't say that make sure the job guests are on time is not important. Also important, but we must choose the four tasks to higher priority. Do you understand what I mean? The key in where?
Yes.
Yeah, thank you. And I want one more student to ask my question to him. What is the chain? Yeah, to run. It's
like,
okay.
I don't know why, but I'm quite opposite with your ideas actually.
Oh,
so
why?
As far as I understand from now, your fourth choice of task,
yeah,
is that the higher priority than others?
Yeah.
The before this, but I'm quite opposite. I choose,
yeah,
the other four tasks is higher priority than the other four.
Yeah, I why?
So
why?
I choose. Can you turn back the slide, please?
Yeah.
Like number one, number three, number five, and number seven.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not understand the term here, but I think this task is quite like it is not as important as the other four, because like you have to implement the change you believe number four. You have to make sure everyone understand that you're in control. Make sure your job get on time is punctuality, and make sure you set a clear expectation and policy. Those four, I think, is the base and like the foundation of the management. Like whenever you manage something, I think those four is like the basic one. So I'm not quite sure that I'm totally right, but my opinion from now, as far as I know, is quite opposite. So can you explain to me?
Yes,
about that?
Thank you for your sharing your opinions. Yeah, that's very, that's I will explain. Yes, I will explain, of course, I will explain the reason why we do the number 1, 3, 5, and 7. The most important of the manager start you set up and maintain your relationship with other people, not the most important, because someone say that management is the way you accomplish your goal through the other people. You cannot do yourself, but you you can complete your objective, your goals through other people. So you must set a relationship with other people. It's very important. In the item number one, you has many your employees, yeah, and your staff, you do the good your task. If your employee do the good the task, so you must spend many time to care, yeah, and fixing, and you can help if your employee they have difficult, yeah, have difficult to do their work. You must help them. And if your employee has low motivation, you must motivate them. So if your employee works, do the good task, you can do your task, because you complete your task through all the people. And also, the number three, you not in the organization, you not do your task by yourself, but your department must cooperate with other departments. So you have to set up the relationship with other co-worker, yeah, in other department, so they can help you to do your work. And of course, and number item number five, you must spend many time to talk, to listen, especially to listen to your subordinates, because you can understand what are they thinking. What they feel difficult about they work, you can help them to do. So you must spend many time, as much possible to talking and listening to your subordinates. And of course you also spend many time to meet your boss, and discuss with his or her, and to understand what his or her expect from you and your department. It's very important. And also the other force also important, but you must set high priority. Priority for to set and maintain the relationship with others. Yeah, that's the most important of management. And after the finish of this chapter, you will see. Item number two, number four, number six, and number eight is maybe suitable for a logical type of management. And the two-day type of management, is the focus on the people. Today management focus on people. On the former or the classical management focus on the rules or regulation. So any other question? Yeah. With Linh Đỗ.
Can you move the slide?
Yeah, they speak louder.
Can you open the slide of the eight?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Yes, so here we have the fifth priority. So you say let's spend as much time as possible talking and listening to subordinate. But actually, in the last scales, if you are the managers and you have to manage about 50 per people, and if you just listen to all of them, then it's really a waste of time. And I think that if your subordinate keep asking you questions and they become depend on you, so that will really bad for them because they cannot think on themselves, and it cannot really help them to grow their abilities in the future. So what do you think about it?
Yeah, thank you for your question. Very interesting. And who in the last happy to answer with the question? This though mean that if you have many subordinates, so how can you talk and listen to all of them?
Me, I think that your opinion is, I know that the market is a battlefield and there are many like enemies in the economy, in the market. And the thing that you have to find out is you have to understand how the feelings of the employment, because you are a leader and a leader must monitor the employment, the employees, to gain as much efficiency as possible. So I think that the most important thing we have to do first is how to listen and find a similarity both of the employments and the manager. And I think that the number 2, 4, 6, 8 is a must have of a manager, and the 4, 1, 3, 5, 7 is depends on each people, and that's how I understand.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Bảo Duy, Mr. Bảo Duy, and Mr. Thu Lan.
Yes, I think that some of us are quite confused here. So, but after the explanation, your explanations, I'm quite understand now. The priority that you said is for. So the main focus here is about humans, and I'm not saying that none of the tasks is not important, but like I said before, some of them are the foundation and some of them are optional for some certain manager. So I guess that your point here is to like focus on the human, like on people, interact with each other and interact with the manager. So I'm quite after you about the 4 top priorities. So for the some other people that are not understand too. So the main focus here is about human and people. So that is the obviously the priority.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's an excellent answer. Yeah, thank you, Mr. Tura. And you with the question. You will know clearly about when you study about in chapter 10 about the subordinate, how many subordinate is the manager has. It's about the we will talk many about, because in you can explain in the company. For example, you are director of company with a thousand employees. But you can but the direct subordinate of you not all the thousand employees of the company. It may be just about 5 people or 6 people, about maybe fire your deputy general director, for example. You just subordinate your deputy general director, and your subordinate has other subordinates, many level. It's not you cannot many on the people in your employee in your company. We talk more really about this in the chapter 10 when we talk about the organization of the structure. And now, and thank you for all your question and your answer, your discussion. And we move to that. So I think now all of you can answer why innovative management matter. Now I think all of you now. Who can tell me why you can turn on your mic and answer. You can turn on because I'm in the PowerPoint screen. I cannot see who raised hand, but you can turn on the mic.
Can I answer the questions, please?
Yeah. I think example like Yahoo or Nokia, because they have slow innovation, so they become extinct from the market, like Yahoo and Nokia.
I that is difficult to hear Mr. Thing. Can you repeat the answer?
I say that like Nokia or Yahoo, they because of slow innovation, they extinct from the market because of the slow innovation.
Yeah, what about the innovation problem of the market? And thank you, Mr. Thịnh, and Mr. Quang Nam. And Mr. Minh Thư.
So I want to say about the LG Corporation in Korea. It's not bankrupt, but it's completely go out from the mobile industry and continue with the other technology device, yeah. Because they can come up with any new and unique idea about the mobile industry, and the operation in the corporation in Korea, like own people use the Samsung, and yeah, it's completely failed in that aspect.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for thank you. Yes, many example you can give. For me, that's my about Nokia. Nokia used to the biggest company in mobile phone. In 2005. Nokia has biggest share market share in the world with about 50% market share in the world. But after about 7 years, Nokia bankrupt and must to the Microsoft. Because Nokia is slow in the changing to to adapt with the new trend, that's the smartphone. And all the, maybe the Kodak. Do you know Kodak?
Is this a film?
Yeah, a film, yeah. And today we do not use film to for your camera. So but Kodak cannot change. Yeah, so they fail. And what do you think about the company? Microsoft, Apple, yeah. And they go, could they go bankrupt or fail in the future?
No.
I think it's because they are ever changing. They constantly change their product and improve their customer experience. Yes, so I don't think in the near future we can see the bankruptcy soon.
Yeah, thank you. And other idea, yeah, please.
I think this company will everlasting because their markets are quite wide, and also many users in the world know clearly about what these companies are doing or what kind of products they produce for the customers. And I think in the future these companies might cooperate together to create some super modern technology or some kind of products for a better world or something like that. Yeah,
thank you. Yeah, of course, the company is very, very famous. Yeah, and very big, have very big market share, and also has a wide market in the world. But if the company they don't do innovative or change in the near future, they also may go to bankrupt or fail in the market if they don't make the innovative. For example, Microsoft, what the focus market of Microsoft? It was. Yes, please. Turn on your microphone.
So I think that the main point that Microsoft is focusing on is releasing the Office software and also the operating system like Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10, and the latest one, the Windows 11.
Yeah.
And it's really widely well known and used by many users. So, yeah, I think that is the goal.
Yeah, of course. Exactly. The Microsoft, very big company in the PC software, operating system and application software in PC field, personal computer. Yeah. But you can explain in the near future, you change to you mobile phone and tablet, notebook. Yeah. I think Microsoft will difficult to because Microsoft they slow to switch they to from PC to mobile phone. Mobile phone. Switch they slow. Slowly to switch from PC to smartphone. And also Bill Gates said that the most rarest of him that they not pay more extension on the mobile market or mobile field. So Microsoft, if one day but I think in the near future, PC will slow the sale. The market share of PC will slow down, and the market share of smartphone and tablet will increase. Now we use the laptop because we can type, we can input your data to the computer quickly. But in the near future, maybe the voice, the voice can recognize the goods. You can control your device by your voice. I think computer will, PC will not exit, and you will change to will change to you the mobile phone and tablets. And also for Apple is the first company provide the smartphone to the market. And for a long time, Apple is the leading company in the smartphone market. But now, Apple they pay attention more on the commercial, on the finance. But the innovation, they slow down. They innovative. So the market share of Apple today is also slow down today. I will show you the market share of Apple here. This is about the market share in February in 2020. Yeah. Now sample Samsung number one, and Apple and Huawei and Xiaomi. Xiaomi, Oppo, and if Apple don't, I mean that if Apple big, despite of Apple either the first company they produce smartphone and provide smartphone to the market, and they had very big company. But if Apple don't pay more attention on the technology innovation, Apple will slow down. Maybe they fail if they don't pay more attention on the innovation. So I not just talk about the Pacific company, but I want to tell you that on company, if they don't pay more, pay attention on innovation, they will go bankrupt in near future. They fail, may fail, and they will not in near future. Why? Who can explain why?
Because there will be new brains and more updates information. So if they don't make any innovation, so that they will be outdated.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Van. Very good. Because the world today is changing quickly. Changing quickly. The technology and the customer and the economic and many things changing, also about culture changing and extending quickly. So if the a company they want to exit in the market today, they must be flexible. So company only can be flexible if they focus on innovative and change and innovative. That's no why. So the answer why innovative management matter today is that the today markets, today environment is changing quickly. So company must quickly adapt with the environment, with the markets. So it's the innovative new imperative for all company, all organization. And we move forward to the definition of management. This is the definition. Management is the attainment of organizational goals in an effective and efficient manner through planning, organizing, leading, and controlling organization resources. So from this definition, there are two important things you have to remember from this definition of management. Just about management is to attain the organizational goals in an effective and efficient. That's one. And the second, that's the four functions of the management. That's planning, organizing, leading, and controlling. Yes, there are two important ideas in this definition. So we go to the four functions of management. Yeah, we can. There are four functions, and it's the most important of management knowledge when you study this course. You must remember the four functions of management. That's about the planning, organizing, and leading, and controlling. You must remember, don't forget this, because when you are a manager, what work you have to do? You have to do four tasks. First, planning. The second is organization. And the third is leading, and the fourth is controlling. That's very important. And we have four parts in your textbook to study about the four person of management: the factory planning, factor organizing, organizing, and factor leading, and factor 6 controlling. Very important. So planning, what is planning? You can remember, planning that is setting goals,
and the ways. Try now the way to extend the goals. That's planning. And the result of planning, you had a plan. You had a plan. And I also tell you the most important plan of a company or a organization, that's the strategic plan. More, the very important, the most important. That's a planning. And the second person, a organization, managing about this, about you have a land. So you, the land, so that you have many tasks to do. Yeah, many tasks to do. So the organizing that we assign the responsibility for task to accomplish. You can divide, you must divide based on your planning, your plan. You divide your company to many department, and you assign the responsibility. Each department do some tasks, and you assign people and resources for department to do, to complete the plan, complete the your company plan. It's the land, so the organizing is depend on the land. Yeah, it's about the second person, and the third person leading. You have the plan, and you assign the responsibility for people and department to do the land, and why, and you must give the motivation and influence to for people they can so they can do the work. So leading do that person leading, that you give the influence to motivate, to motivate your employee to do the land, to do the work. So that's it about the leading person. And the last person, controlling. You must monitor the activity of the company, and you must keep the activity to progress to the land. And must do follow the land of the company. So the controlling, monitor the activity, and maybe make if needs, you can make the correction, adjust your activity to do, so you can accomplish the land. That's about four functions of management: planning, managing, and leading and controlling. So who can give me example? Of planning and managing, leading and controlling? You need one person. Only one person. Yeah. Miss Ngọc Mai.
Hello, teacher. But in my opinion, example for this is if you want to go to if you want to go to a picnic in the weekend, then you must plan the picnic that you want to attend with your family, and then you organize like prepare for your food and places or anything, and then you leading is you invite them to invite your family member to go with you, and then you control. It means you are you assign them to this one is set up the tent, and the other is cooking food, and then lay some other activities. It's the end. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Miss Ngọc Mai. Mean that you will plan a picnic, make a picnic plan for the weekend. So you must first you set the goals, of the picnic, what you can to achieve, you want to achieve, of the picnic. And after that you list on the work, on the task you need to do for the picnic. Yeah. Thank you very much for your answer, for example. And mời Gia Hoàng.
So for instance, if you are given a school project, for example, you have to think first, what is the school project and how to accomplish it? And you have to plan the ways to finish the school project. And after that, you have to organize the plan, how to do it properly. Like you will have to divide this work for team one, the other work for team two, to make the work become easier. And after organizing it, you have to command. You have to lead. You have to lead the people in your team to finish the work quickly and efficiently.
Thank you, Mr. Gia Hoa. Very good example. I think this is my lady for you. For example, in the company, you are working in, you are the manager of the sales department in the company. So you make the plan for the year in the 2022, for example. So first, you must set the goals, the objectives of yourself, of your sales department. For example, the revenue, the turnover must be about 1 million for the year of 2022. That's the goal. And you list many tasks, many work to achieve the goals. That how your revenue, your turnover gets the million, what 1 million in the next year. Maybe learn to you must about the million customer, for example. And to get million customer, you must have advertising on network, social network, and on the television channel, for example, and many tasks. So after that, you have a plan yourself, same plan for the next year. And organizing, you have plan. So you see in your sales department, maybe for example, you have 5 people. So the first people, what they will do, and the second, you assign the role, as the responsibility for each people to do the plan, and you give the resources, maybe money, maybe the time, and maybe the tool, equipment for people to do their work. So that's the second. data organizing. And the third function, leading. Yes, you must influence and motivate people. So you might be give the policy about you pay the salary salary the wage salary depend on the sale, depend on the revenue. For example, so your employee must try to buy to sell more more products and service, and they can have a highest revenue, so they can get a high salary. For example, yeah, you set a policy and they motivate them by give they the compliment, give they the praise, vân vân. Yes, and the last function that controlling. You can check point for each the last week you check. You can check who has the revenue of each your employee. So if they cannot guess the target, you will help them, or maybe you find some more employee to do the work. For example, to maybe adjust and make correction to ensure that your revenue target must list in next year. For example, that's about the four function of management, that's the planning, managing, leading, and controlling. And we go back to the organization performance. Organizational performance. And before we go to the organizational performance, we must know the definition of organization. They are very short definition. Organization that is a social entity. That social organization is social entity that evolves directives and deliberate the structure. So I can explain you there are three points in this definition. First, the organization is a social entity. That means that organization must have two or more people. We found a social entity. So social, that's must two or more. And goal directives means that organization they has a specific goals for all people in the organization to focus on the goals of the organization. They had a goals. For example, a company that make profits. Or for my example, that's for a sales department, that's the revenue, the sale target. And the third idea, that's deliberately structured. That means that the task on organization, the tasks are divided and flexibility for my own people in the organization, assigned to on member, on each member. So we also assign the staff for on a member of the organization. First, we go through to the definition of organization. And
we will go through to the organizational performance. We had to concept first organizational effectiveness, and the second is organizational efficiency. So you can see here, I give you the detail definition of the Abdo concept. First, organizational effectiveness is the degree the organization achieve the targets, the objective, achieve the objective. But and organizational efficiencies refer to the amount of resources used to achieve the organizational goals. So you can think it's simple that when you talk about the organizational effectiveness, that means how you achieve the goals, the objective. First, about the organizational efficiencies, this is about how many resources you use to achieve the goals. So who can give me example of organizational effectiveness and organizational efficiencies? Yeah, please. Yes, please. Turn on your microphone.
Can you hear me?
Hello? Please speak loudly.
Can you hear me?
It's very.
Can you hear me?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. I'll have an example about the organizational efficiency. During the pandemic, pharmacy store want to sell more masks, for example, and they have to reduce the money of delivery the mask to the city because there are a lot of lockdown areas and all the money to in order to achieve the best profit. So that's one example about the efficiency.
Yeah, thank you. That's very good. It's reduce the cost. Yeah. You mean let's reduce the cost. The cost of delivery. And about the organizational effectiveness. Who can give me an example of this concept?
Excuse me?
Yeah.
I think for example, like the my friend said before, during the pandemic, the need for face masks and the test kit is really high, and as a company, we target at the products that the consumer value the most. So I think we focus on the products that the customer needs.
Yeah, okay, on the products and customer needs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you. It's about my example about the sales department. The target for the next year is about one million. Yeah, 1 million. So if finished the year 2020 and 2022, the sales target of my sales department
we can get we can get we can sell with the turnover the revenue million 1 million or more. That mean I has effectiveness. My department has effectiveness. As beyond is the just the compare the outcome. The effectiveness, that we compare the outcome with the target, the objective. We compare the outcome, and the efficiency. We compare the resources used or the cost. How many resources you use to achieve the objective? Yeah, that's the very high. That is two important concept to evaluate the organizational performance. And we go to the next point. That's about the management skills. There are three category of skill that are conceptual, human, and technical. So manager to do four function: planning, organizing, leading, and controlling. Manager must have three sky of skill to do the four function of management. Yeah. First is conceptual and human and technical. About the conceptual skill. That is the mental ability to see the organization as a who and the relationship among each part. The conceptual. For example, you are director of a company. You must feel your company with the relationship between the department in your company, and you must see and you must give your assessment about the situation of your company. For example, that's about the conceptual skill. So this skill is very important for the stock managers about the conceptual skill. I emphasize that on the three skills very on the categories. Conceptual, human, and technical is important for on manager. But the top manager, they must focus more on the conceptual skill. And the second is human skill. This is about ability to work and work with and through other people. Yeah. You can collaborate and motivate, lead people and communicate with people. That's the human skill. And the last is the technical skill. That's about your understanding about the specific field you work. For example, when you work in the company in the software, you must have knowledge and skill in software. When you work in the hospital, you must have skill in medicine. And when you work in the finance, you must have skill about finance and knowledge and skill about finance. That's here we call the technical skill. And the technical skill are more important, and the more important at the lower organization levels. For example, the first class manager, you will talk after about the level of manager in organization. So we go through to something you can list in your textbook and your slide, and we go through to the time, yeah, management time. So there are two way of divide to management time, vertical and horizontal. When divide in in organization, when you talk about the vertical, that mean if you the flows of top down and bottom up, that mean the vertical. Yeah, that mean here is the vertical in an organization. Yeah, vertical. So based on the vertical, we divide manager to three level. First, the top managers, and the middle manager, and first line manager. Three level. About the top manager, there might be CEO, and maybe the board of director or board of management in the company or in the organization as their top manager. And top manager, they must focus on the whole company, and focus on the strategic plan for company. So that's why the top manager must focus on the conceptual skill, because they must care company at the whole. And about the middle managers, this is maybe about the business unit has, for example, do you know Vingroup?
Yes,
Vingroup, yeah. And Vingroup, maybe Mr. Phạm Nhật Vượng, maybe a top manager. Yeah. And the middle manager, the manager, for example, manager of VinFast, manager of VinMax, manager of VinGenie, VinSchool, for example, that's the middle manager. And the first line manager, that's people, they heads of personal division in the company. For example, IT, maybe the head of IT department, head of human resource department, and head of accounting department. For example, that's the first line manager. And the last is the employee, the worker, the staff. Yeah, so based on the vertical, we have three level of the manager. And you also know why the first line manager, for the first line manager, the technical skill very important, because they do the operational task. So they must have the technical skill. Yes, you can see in that's the store manager, middle manager, and first line manager. And where in the chapter 10, I will tell you about project manager. And divide into based on the horizontal. Yeah, horizontal. In
in an organization. For example, on that, it shows the coordination between department in the company, the coordination. Yeah, I mean. Maybe in the company, the sales department coordinate with the accounting department, accounting department, and coordinate with the technical department. For example, that's we call that the horizontal. And based on the horizontal, we classify manager to the functional manager and general manager. Personal manager, that's people who are responsible for departments that perform a single function task and have employee with similar training and skills. For example, a chief accountant and a functional manager, for example. And general manager, people who are responsible for several departments that perform different functions. I will show you the example. For example, human resource management. So heads of human resource department, that's the functional manager. And heads of marketing, functional manager. Heads of purchasing department, functional manager. And managing director who are responsible for on of department, we call the general manager. And functional manager, we can divide into two types of functional managers. That's line managers and task managers. Line manager are responsible for the manufacturing and marketing department that make or sell the products and service. And task manager are in charge of departments such as finance, personnel that support the line departments. So you can see in this structure and spoil down. What is the line? Yeah, the line department and what is the staff department in this structure? And what is the line manager and staff manager in the structure? Can you see this structure? Is clear for you? Yeah, please open, turn on your microphone.
I think the line manager is the marketing manager, and the staff manager is the accounting department.
Yeah, good. Exactly. Yeah. Maybe in this organizational structure, marketing manager and maybe production manager, also the line manager. Yeah, as a manager. And accounting manager or shipping manager is and they are the staff managers. Thank you. Yeah, and we go move forward, and I have just about half an hour to finish the last. And we go forward. That's we compare the work and the staff, the performance between the individual and manager.
compare? What the difference? What the difference? Also, you can compare with the work, the staff of an employee and a manager. What's the difference? Yeah. You can see in the slide. That's there are four difference. But when we work with when you are an employee, you do the specific task, sometimes one task, three tasks, for example, but specific. But when you are manager, you must work as the general task, and coordinate and you call that a diverse task. For example, when you are a salesman, work in the sales department, maybe you have only task to sell many products possible. But when you are a sales manager, you handle many tasks. Also, you also must focus on the sale product and service, but you also do on the employees human resource. Employee maybe the paperwork, maybe about your about the contract. You must focus on the contract. Focus on your employee to motivate your employee. For example, many tasks you must do. And the second thing that when you work from when you are employees, maybe you get things done from your own efforts. The work, if you try to work hard, you can finish your task sooner. But when you are manager, you get things done through orders. Your task, your duty if accomplished depend on orders, on your employees. And the third, that when you are employee, you are an individual actor, but when you are manager, you must a network builder. So you must focus on to set relationship with your subordinate, relationship with your peers, relationship with your boss. Many relationship. And the last thing that when you are work from the individuals, you can work independently, but when you are manager, you work in highly interdependent manner. Must depend on your employee, depend on order to finish the work. So that's explain why you must focus more when the most important you focus on the relationship with others, because your work depend on others. That's the difference between when you work with the individual identity and the manager identity. And the next we will talk about this the characteristic of managers, characteristics about the manager.
do you really want to be a manager? Really want? Yes, Lee.
Yes, I think it's kind of great to be a manager, although there's some workload to do and a lot of pressure, but I think this is a great opportunity to grow up and be more like have a good job in life.
Yeah, fine. That's interesting. Yeah, very good. Yeah, but when we really you want to be a manager, you must know what you face in the future. First, you must face the increases of work loss. You must do many work, many things to work. The more pressure for you when you are manager. And the second, maybe the challenge of supervising former peer. Maybe some people in the past, they are your co-worker, but now you are the boss. It's the difficult for you to supervise them. And the most important that when you are manager, you have a responsibility for your employees. You must be responsible for your employees. It's very important. For example, when you are a director of the company, and your company has 100 employees, and you know, you has responsible for their lives, for your employee lives, for how today to improve their life, improve their professional and improve their work, improve their salary, and also behind your employee, one behind which is your employee is a family. It's very important. So you might be head chair of the facility for your employees. So if you really want to be manager, you must know what you face in the future and you accept. You must really to face. And about the manager activities. They are the research of a very famous researcher, Minberg. He is the observed many manager, and he conclude some of that activity of manager. First the manager they must doing the multitask. Doing the multitask. And usually manager use less than 9 minutes on one activity to decide on one activity. The manager has less than 9 minutes. And the manager must very flexible of the schedule and the workload must flexible because many tasks come to the manager. So that's the manager also has the very high pressure of, that's why manager high pressure of in the works and have it. Yeah. You raise your hand. Yeah, this one.
Yes. Can you give an example for less than 9 minutes on most activities? You did explain it, but I didn't get it.
That means usually manager they had very few time to solve the problem, to solve the work, to do the work. So, because for example, once they when you go to your company, at first you must to sign all the contract, sign all the document on the table. Your employee and when you are signing your the document, you receive a call from the customer. They complain about your product, complain about your service. So you call to the customer support to ask them to solve the problem. And maybe you can get a phone from the partner, your partner about the complaint about they see the money from company, for example, many things. So manager must do many tasks, multi tasks. So they have a few time to do the task.
So that is they just have few times, just not exactly 9 minutes to decide anything, right?
That's based on the heavy member research.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. And next, I will tell about the manager roles. Also, based on the visions of Minberg, he has shown that there are 10 roles of manager, 10 roles. And to do the four functions of management, the manager must lay the 10 roles. Yeah. That's the role that the expectation of manager behavior, 10 role. And the 10 role that's divided into three group: informational, interpersonal, and decisional. And in first about the informational, there are three, the manager had three roles about monitor, this discriminator and spokesman. And about the interpersonal manager had three roles, also had three roles about the figurehead, leader and liaison, and about the decisional roles, manager had four roles about general and disturbance handler, resources allocator, negotiator, that's four roles. So you can get explain for this. Yeah. Miyang, can you ask question?
Sorry for interrupt you.
Yeah.
Are you going to explain on the roles? Because after you explain, I will have a question.
Yeah, you can ask question first.
Okay.
Are you going after I explain the roles?
Okay, I will wait after you explain.
Yeah. Okay. Of course. Yeah, I will explain the role. First, about the informational roles. Sorry, I have gone and I will back. Okay. Yeah, I explain the roles. About the informational roles, there are three, manager has three roles. First, about the monitor. That means that the manager had a role to seeking for the role to seek the information about the organization and the environment, yeah, to get the information. And the second role, determination, that's the determinator, that the manager had to, when they has information, they had to change the information to others in the organization, to communicate, to make a communication system to change the information to others. And the third is spokesperson. So that manager, they may on behalf of the organization to talk to all to outside about the organization. That's first about the three roles in the informational roles. And after in the group number two, that interpersonal roles. That mean interpersonal, that mean the relationship with others. So the manager had three roles. First, figurehead role. Figurehead role. That's maybe the manager, they are involved in ceremony or symbolic function for the audition. For example, they on behalf of the audition, they go to for example, and the president of US, and they on behalf of the US, they go to open, for example, opening ceremony of all the university. So that's the figurehead role, for example, figurehead role. And the second it is the leader role. Leader, that means you set up the relationship and motivate, influence and motivate your employees. And the third, that the liaison role, that mean you are the connection point for people inside and outside your organization to connect with you. That's the liaison role. And the I see the decisional roles. There are four roles of the manager, but the general roles. That mean people, they has manager, but the people has a new idea or innovative idea for the organization. And the second, that's the determinant handler roles. This is about when there are conflict between your subordinates or between your department, you must you show the conflict, for example. And the third, that resource allocator. That means you can allocating your resources to your subordinate. And the last, that negotiator. That's about negotiation between with other department or with other organization or the company or your organization. That's the 10 manager roles.
So, okay. Okay. Jack, can you ask the question?
Yes. So in the 10 roles, I see it in the information, no? We have the spokesperson, and in the decisional, we have negotiator.
Yeah.
And I see that both of them have the same role at transmitting the information to the outsider. So why do we put them into one role?
Roles with the spokesperson.
Spokesperson and yes. Negotiator.
Spokesperson and negotiation.
Why do we? Why don't we put it into one role? Because I find them pretty.
You think the same? Yeah. You think it might be the same roles?
Yes, in my opinion.
Yeah. Okay, I understand your question. It's not the same roles. The spokesperson, for example, for spokesperson. When your journalist want to interview to tell about US, for example, interview about the new strategy of US in the future. So, who will representative to talk about the US strategy for the journalist? It must be president, the resident of US, or maybe a chairman of US. We spoke to outside, to the public, outside the company. That's the an example of the spokesperson.
Yeah.
Yeah. And about the negotiator role. For example, we had a contract. We had a contract with, for example, US had a contract with the other university, and we signed a contract, and we must negotiate to about the fee, about this, for example, many things. So the resident of the US must do that story about a negotiator to maintain the benefits, the outcome of the US with other.
Yeah, okay. So yeah. The negotiator, like we have to have a discussion.
Yeah, because you must make the decision. But about the information, the spokesman first just give the information about your organization.
Oh, okay.
Outside.
Thank you
for your question, Minh Giang. And Mai Lâm.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Unlike Zhang, I think that between negotiator and figurehead, they share the same similarity, because I see in the description of the role, they are also signed the documents, and they are basically they are like legal representatives. So, can you tell me the details of what is their similarities and what is their differences?
Yes, thank you. With the negotiator and the figurehead. About the figurehead, it's about in the interpersonal role. That's the role of the relationship between others, between other people, between other organizations, for example. So figurehead that you on behalf of your organization, you go to make the relationship with other organization. That's the figurehead. First, about the negotiation. This way is focused on the decision. You bargain to extend the benefits, the outcome for your organization. This focus on the decision. What you can for example, when you sign a contract, what you can you bargain with your supplier, for example, about the rise, about the delivery the condition, for example, many things, the maintenance, that's the you negotiate with your supplier, and you must decision how we can accept, we can sign, how condition we can sign the contract, even accept, must make the decision. And first, about the international roles, we have just go out and set the relationship with others. Not focus on decision. Do you understand? It's my.
Yeah, I see. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. And Sunda.
Oh yeah. I have a question in about the disseminator. Disseminator that a manager must have. If you disseminate an information inside and outside, I think you have to be like a storage of information. So you have to contain so many information. And as far as I know, nowadays there are many information system that can support you. Yeah, they can support you very effectively. So my question is that why do we have to disseminate information instead of using the technology, the modern technology that we have?
Yeah, thank you. It's very interesting question. This the disseminator role does not mean that you must talk direct to your subordinate. That's the role that you this mean role that you must set up a communication system for your company that you can transmit the information or to on the subordinate your the subordinate to has the they can have enough information to do their work, the task. That's me. Not you. For example, you can use the computer system.
Oh, I see. Yeah. So we should use the technology that we have. Yeah.
Yeah. You can use the technology to help you to transmit information to others.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you for your question. Yeah, and Thi Han.
So, I have a question about the liaison role.
Yeah, liaison. Yeah.
Yes, I really don't know what you mean by the development of the information source. So, can you explain more about that, please?
Yeah, liaison.
Thank you.
Yeah. I give you example. When I share you my experience,
when I am a director in my company. Yeah, there are many information I can share from my subordinates.
Okay.
For internal, because sorry. Alo, em qua anh Bình ơi. Chị bây giờ cho rồi chờ em tí xíu nhé. Rồi em vô không đi. The doctoral writing company in committee asked me to join the committee, because this committee has started at 2 p.m. and I said that I will join late, so we will finish hurry and we stop for this night. I talking about the liaison roles. As for example, when you are manager, we must to be the connecting point for the internal and external. For example, when your employee, they have problem, they have something, they feel sad, they feel happy, for example, they can, if you are, they want to share, they want to support, and they don't know who to talk about, talk to you, you can find, they can talk to you, manager, you can share their thinking, share their problem, share their happy, for example, many things. So you must to be the connecting point or in the internal and outside the company, outside your organization. For example, when I'm a director, and for example, in our system has a problem, and our customer, they connect, they call to my employee, but they cannot call, and maybe sometime the midnight, they call me, your problem breakdown, so you must support, okay, and I must be the connect people to if for people inside and outside the company to connect, if they don't know who to connect, who to call, they must connect you. That's the role of the liaison role of the manager.
Okay, I've understood. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, so it's now 3 p.m. So I must stop and go to the committee assignment. Yes, hurry me.
So, teacher.
Yeah.
There are also one questions in the chat box from Thanh Thu.
Yeah, that's true. Explain the difference between the leader and manager. Okay, leader and manager. We will compare the leader and manager in the chapter 15. When you talk about leader, 15, or you can, or first you can read the slide PowerPoint and the textbook the compare with leader manager.
Teacher?
Yeah.
I can see that the PDF files that you send out is
I will send maybe tonight I will send this textbook to Mr. Thảo Nguyên and Mr. and Thanh Thương. Yeah, I will send to Thảo Nguyên and Thanh Thương, and Thảo Nguyên Thanh Thương will share for the last.
Yes, teacher.
Yeah, because it's the I just share personally. I cannot upload to the last on the LMS system. So thank you very much again. Thank you very much for your arranging time to attend the last at Miss Day. And next Friday we will time last at 1 p.m. You can log in early about 10 minutes, and we will start exactly at 1 p.m. Any question? Okay. The last question for you. Who is the supervisor of your class?
Miss Amy.
Amy. Yeah, Amy. Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much. And see you next week. And I am very I'm happy with your discussion and your question, your answer. Very good. And I need you to read the textbook chapter two, and the slide and textbook chapter two before we start the last next Friday. Thank you very much.
Thank you, teacher.
Goodbye.
See you next week.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Yeah.
Goodbye.